Hello. So we have landed at the Damdama Hotel. Damdama Hotel
this
or Resort?
This is the Haryana government-run resort.
Surprisingly, it's very close to the place where we just while away time unnecessarily.
Dadu ki tarah, main aur Yuvraj aake धूप में खड़े हो जाते थे, एक घंटा बातें कर रहे थे, बिस्किट खाते थे और वापस जाके जैन चिकनजी पे जाके पीते थे।
पेड़ की छाया के नीचे बैठ खड़े होते हो ना तुम लोग?
कई बार तो धूप में भी, कई बार छाया भी नहीं मिलती,
कोई जगह ही नहीं है बैठने के लिए।
हम जैसे बेवकूफ लोग यहाँ आ जाते
हैं
यार।
It's a good break. So you'll not feel drained out after doing half the train. आराम से आके खाओ पियो।
2024 आधा खत्म हो चुका है। मैं 2020 से यहाँ पे बाइक चला रहा हूँ, मैं यहाँ कभी नहीं आया।
But the ride was very draining today, and hence we are doing our second glass of chikanji.
Yes.
Any thoughts on the
desert excellence
on the stuff that you have done today?
So, let me begin by saying that I dropped the Ducati Desert Excellence. I was crossing a little bit of slush, and the rear slid. I couldn't control
the,
it.
The rear slid. The rear or slid. The front.
The rear.
Huh? It happened like this. Yeah. How did it happen? You applied the brakes or what?
No. I was just letting it go. Okay. I don't know. Maybe I lost the front. Maybe I lost the front. I'll have to review the footage.
Hmm.
I lost the front and then the rear slid because I was trying to control it.
So the bike is now balanced basically.
He dropped it on the left. I dropped it on the right.
I dropped
side.
It unnecessarily because I was trying to do an elephant turn, and doing this on a 910 mm seat height was very challenging. It must be a scratch on the right side.
There is nothing on the
right
side.
Because you dropped it on the mud.
I dropped it on mud, so there is no damage to the motorcycle, nothing. It was a very slow speed fall.
Yeah. But then I also tested out the crash guard, right, properly. I dropped it on hard gravel.
Fuck.
So that's good. And this bike will eventually fall. This is a rally motorcycle, right?
See, exactly. That's the whole point. And this sort of begs the question. Are you willing to take a 27 lakh rupee motorcycle off-road?
It's a very tough question. If it is my money, then I will think 10 times before getting it on this trail. And even if I get it, I'll not ride it the way it is meant to be ridden. It will be very cautious approach, right? In terms of protecting the bike and being away from the bike for like 6 months, 4 months, if there is some sort of a damage that happens to the part.
I feel this Ducati is a great travel motorcycle. It is a motorcycle that you take to Ladakh and Zanskar, and there where the roads are winding and open and broken, like gravel roads, dirt patches, that is where you have more fun than anything else on the road.
But then why would you need a rally for that? You can do that very well on the standard desert X, which is an amazing motorcycle,
absolutely.
Right? 5 lakhs cheaper also, right?
Yes, but so here is the point of this motorcycle.
Hmm.
And I was saying this while riding the Himalayan behind you.
Hmm.
To me, this motorcycle is a halo product. Okay, this is a what if motorcycle. मतलब किसी ने Ducati में सोचा that what if we make an ultimate travel motorcycle which can go anywhere and do anything. So money no bar, let's try and throw everything that we can on this motorcycle. So just look at the components on this bike. This motorcycle comes with suspension which is honestly inspired from motocross and enduro. This is a KYB closed cartridge suspension. तेरे को पता है closed cartridge का फायदा क्या होता है?
हाँ, उसके अंदर oil जो होता है उसमें bubbles नहीं बनता,
उसमें air bubbles नहीं बनते, ज़्यादा use होके heat होने पे. So
it performs as expected in all sorts of conditions.
Yes, it will. The feel will always be very consistent. Look at the suspension travel, 250 millimeters at the front, 240 at the rear.
That's massive. Honestly, I was riding it
better than anything that I've ever experienced.
I cannot utilize the suspension capability, right? We can't. It requires very hard riding and a lot of confidence and skill.
Actually, maine aaj tak 200 mm
What is the ground clearance of this motorcycle?
I think it's 280 mm.
Really?
Yeah.
But it's huge, whatever it is. Yeah.
Haan, so
and this one is not equipped with the carbon bash plate?
So no. It came with a carbon bash plate, this motorcycle from factory. But this motorcycle, the one that we are riding, it has the off-road protection package on it.
Okay.
So off-road protection package jo hai na, wo 160,000 rupees ke aaspaas aata hai. Haan. And usme,
itna toh aayega, haan, samajh
gaya. This is a 27 lakh rupee motorcycle. Everything on this motorcycle will be priced accordingly. So usme kya aata hai? Usme tumhe knuckle guards mil jate hain. उसमें तुमको
क्रैश बार्स
मिल जाती है और उसमें तुमको ये बैश प्लेट मिल जाती है एल्युमिनियम. ब्रेक्स आर फिनोमिनल, हमें अच्छी
सब में अच्छी आती है, ब्रेम्बो
सब में अच्छी आती है. ठीक है, ओलिंस का स्टीयरिंग डैम्पनर एज स्टैंडर्ड, बिलेट ट्रिपल क्लैम्प्स होता है जो उसको सस्पेंशन को आगे के सस्पेंशन को होल्ड करता है. एल्यूमिनियम टाकासागो रिम्स है. नाउ द स्टैंडर्ड रिम्स दे कैन टेक अ लॉट ऑफ बैशिंग बट दीज रिम्स आर स्ट्रॉन्गर. दे आर मेड ऑफ अ हायर ग्रेड एल्यूमिनियम. दे आर नैरोअर सो द टायर प्रोफाइल टायर साइज वही है बट द टायर it curves more so it handles better off road.
They have also mentioned that they are not protruding out.
Yeah,
so that means they are protected from rocks and everything.
Yes. So that is the whole point of not having those tubeless spoke rims. Usme jo edges hoti hai usme spoke end hota hai
wahan pe takla ke
patthar laga na
toot sakta hai.
So I was having a conversation with a Triumph ex employee. Main ye Himalayan leke gaya tha apne uske paas Anupam. Ha to main uski workshop pe ek bar gaya tha. I took the new Himalayan. The first thing we are running the tubeless spoke rims. The first thing he said was mujhe rim pasand nahi hai. मैंने बोला क्यों? मैंने बोला तो ट्यूबलेस है. कहता है इसमें ना ये साइड से चिप हो जाता है ना तो पूरा रिम खराब हो जाता है. यू कैन डू एनीथिंग आफ्टर दैट. यू कैन फिक्स इट. सो दैट इज द रीजन व्हाई दिस मोटरसाइकिल डजंट कम विद ट्यूबलेस स्पोक रिम्स एंड इट कम्स विद अ हायर ग्रेड एल्यूमिनियम टाकासागो. इसका जो स्पोक है वो भी कार्बन
स्टील एल्यूमिनियम.
ठीक है. देन इसका जो हब है वो भी मशीन एल्यूमिनियम है. द मनी द 5 लाख रुपीज मेरे को लगता है सस्पेंशन की वैल्यू ही इसकी 5 लाख रुपए होगी कम से कम. इट कुड बी हायर. सो देर इज अ लॉट ऑफ थॉट दैट हैज बीन अप्लाइड इन बिल्डिंग दिस मोटरसाइकिल. ऑल आई डिड यू नो मैं सारी मोटरसाइकिल्स में उम्मीद करता रहता हूँ मेरे को मालूम अच्छे से. ऑल आई डिड ऑन दिस बाइक वॉज आई टुक ऑफ द रबर फुटपैक्स जो रबर इंसर्ट होता है एंड द हैंडल बार आई मूव्ड इट टू ऑफ रोड पोजिशन एंड द गियर शिफ्ट लीवर मैंने उसको ऑफ रोड पोजिशन में ऊपर करके डाल दिया. और इसमें कोई चेंज की जरूरत ही नहीं है. दी ओनली थिंग दैट आई वुड लाइक ऑन दिस मोटरसाइकिल टू राइड ओवर हियर इज नॉबी टायर्स. मतलब मेरे को रैली STR नहीं मेरे को रैली टायर चाहिए. स्कॉर्पियन रैली चाहिए. आई थिंक आई वुड बी एबल टू राइड बेटर ऑन दिस मोटरसाइकिल विद दैट. सो दीज आर द पार्ट्स दैट आर ऑन दिस मोटरसाइकिल दैट मेक इट सो मच मोर एक्सपेंसिव दैन एनी अदर मोटरसाइकिल इन द मार्केट. इफ द डेजर्ट एक्स स्टैंडर्ड इज 22 लाख रुपीज दिस इज 56,000 57,000 समथिंग लाइक दैट. एंड आई फील फॉर पीपल हु हैव द मनी एंड ये कोई रैशनल डिसीजन नहीं है. इट इज़ अबाउट वॉन्टिंग है ना. मतलब काम तो तेरी टाइगर 900 रैली भी वही करेगी जो ये करेगी. मतलब वी कैनॉट बिकॉज दिस मोटरसाइकिल इज सो ओवर इक्विप्ड. वी कैनॉट हार्नेस हम स्टैंडर्ड डेजर्ट एक्स को भी उसी लेवल पे चला पाएंगे जिसको हम इस पे चला पाएंगे. वी कैनॉट वी डोंट हैव द कैपेबिलिटी टू हार्नेस द पोटेंशियल ऑफ दीज.
बट कमिंग बैक टू द क्वेश्चन इफ समबडी स्पेंड्स द मनी
हाँ इट्स अ फील गुड फैक्टर यार.
दे विल नॉट बी एबल टू राइड इट इन सच टेरेन. द समर स्प्रिंट फॉर एग्जांपल बिकॉज ऑफ द रॉक्स एंड ऑल.
नहीं समर स्प्रिंट इफ इट इज वेट लाइक दिस
इट इज टफ.
इफ समर स्प्रिंट इज ड्राई this bike will fly through summer sprint. I've done it on the regular desert.
I think this
right?
will be a good motorcycle if you are going to Rajasthan as well.
Rajasthan jao
where the, if the bike falls in the dunes and all if you know how to ride it nothing will happen.
Yeah,
so I think that is the
I feel this is a very
the perfect
good,
use case scenario for such a motorcycle.
Yeah.
Where you're not worried the terrain is soft the bike will not get
the
damaged.
Terrain shouldn't be extremely challenging. Like you know September mein you and I did the whole Zanskar and Ladakh circuit. This motorcycle would fly in those conditions.
We should ask for 2 motorcycles. I was thinking about it.
Ek standard aur ek ye wali.
No, both standard. I don't want to worry about puncture na.
Chilla chilla ke sabko apna plan bata de.
Give us 2 Desert X.
No, but it is such a lovely motorcycle. But there is, the bike is great. But what are the flaws in your opinion? पहले मेरे को 2 फ्लॉज लगते हैं इसमें और मेरे को सिर्फ 2 फ्लॉज लगते हैं. प्राइस तो खैर वी ऑल नो वो तो प्राइस इज नॉट अ फ्लॉ यू नो बिकॉज इवन अ 20 लाख रुपी मोटरसाइकिल यू कैन जस्टिफाई. सो अगर ये 27 की भी है वो तो आपके ऊपर डिपेंड करता है. आपके पास पैसा है आप खर्चना चाहते हो आपको अच्छा लगता है. आई
वाज नॉट एबल टू फाइंड एनी मेजर फ्लॉ. मुझे तो सिर्फ थोड़ा बहुत जो इशू हीटिंग के साथ लग रहा था हल्का फुल्का बिकॉज स्लो स्पीड पे इसका फैन बहुत जल्दी ऑन हो रहा था व्हेन आई वाज राइडिंग इट ना. Within 30 seconds the fan was on.
Okay.
And if you as soon as you come at the standstill, वो heat बहुत ज़्यादा लगती है इसमें. अच्छे से लगती है अच्छे से.
तो मैंने traffic में चलाई थी मैं मुझे इतनी गर्मी नहीं लगी. मतलब it was just like any other big bike. It was heating an equivalent amount for me. But there are 2-3 things that I do not like which I wish could be better. First and foremost इसका जो side stand है ना उसका उसमें ना कुछ grab करने के लिए नहीं है. So
that needs an extender.
It needs an extender or it needs a little bit of piece, something that sticks out, which यू नो यू आर एबल टू किक इट डाउन एंड यू आर एबल टू पुल इट बैक
इंट्यूटिवली.
रिट्रैक्ट करने में भी दिक्कत होती है.
ओके
दैट इज वन थिंग दैट आई नोटिस व्हिच कुड बी बेटर. बट दिस इज निट पिकिंग राइट ऑन अ 27 लाख रुपए मोटरसाइकिल. देन आई फील फॉर अ मोटरसाइकिल दैट इज मेंट फॉर ट्रैवल इसकी फ्यूल इकोनॉमी बहुत पुअर है.
कितनी है
मतलब यार ये 14 मेरे को तो 14 की दे दी.
अच्छा
सो यू इफ यू आर रनिंग थ्रू अ टैंक अ 21 लीटर टैंक इन 300 किलोमीटर और लेस. बिकॉज ऐसा तो है नहीं कि तुम इसको सेडेटली चलाओगे. तुम इसको थोड़ा सा स्पिरिटेड ये बाइक
वांट्स यू टू
बेग्स यू टू राइड इन अ स्लाइटली स्पिरिटेड मैनर. हां इट कैन नॉट बी रिडन जेंटली लाइक द टाइगर. इसमें मजा ही है कि इसका लाइक इट वांट्स दैट. सो जब 300 किलोमीटर की रेंज खत्म हो जा रही है दैट इज वेरी पुअर. अ मोटरसाइकिल लाइक दिस शुड डू एटलीस्ट 400 किलोमीटर्स बिकॉज टूरिंग करते हुए दिक्कत होगी ऊपर पहाड़ में. एक्चुअली पहाड़ में माइलेज अच्छी भी देती है बाइक बट स्टिल 400
खुलेगा नहीं ना थ्रॉटल इतना इजी चलेगी.
400 की रेंज तो होनी चाहिए आई फील.
350 देगी मेरे को लग रहा है उससे ज्यादा नहीं देगी. उसके बाद
उसके बाद ना यू
एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट फ्यूल ढूंढना पड़ेगा. व्हेन यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द डिसएडवांटेजेस और द थिंग्स दैट आर नॉट वर्किंग फाइन द फ्यूल गेज इज वेरी इनएक्यूरेट.
हां यार
इट चेंजेस.
या
द डे व्हेन आई टुक द मोटरसाइकिल फ्रॉम योर प्लेस इट वाज शोइंग 62 किलोमीटर्स रेंज एंड बाय द टाइम आई रीच ग्रेटर नोएडा इट वाज शोइंग 142 किलोमीटर्स रेंज.
मैंने ना तेरे को हैंडओवर करने से पहले ₹1000 का फ्यूल भराया था उसमें. How so, ₹1000 का fuel
that's very frustrating. I mean,
show 62 का range. But you know, you get
a brand that prides itself with all these electronics. They should have the fuel gauge calibration.
But the electronics on this motorcycle, did you notice? They are not intrusive. And the electronics on this motorcycle, they are also very intuitive. They are very intuitive. The menu mode. A lot of people find it very confusing. I found it very easy.
No, this was easy. This was very easy. The navigation was easy. Activating different modes is easy. And along with that, when you're talking about the electronics not being intrusive, it's perfectly mapped.
पहले मुझे क्या लगता है I'm an electronics hater, okay? So मेरे को लगता है कि बाइक में सिर्फ राइड बाय वायर भी मत दो. सिर्फ केबल वाला थ्रॉटल होना चाहिए ना. ABS होना चाहिए ना. ट्रैक्शन कंट्रोल होना चाहिए बिकॉज थिंग्स दे इंटरफियर विद योर राइडिंग. इस मोटरसाइकिल में पता ही नहीं चलता. दे आर एडिंग यू सो वेल बिकॉज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स हैव कम सो फार अलॉन्ग फ्रॉम वॉट वी वर यूज टू. जैसे मेरी प्राइमरी adventure motorcycle is my Tiger 1200 which is a 2017 motorcycle registered in 2018 but it's a primarily 2016-2017 technology. Ab 2024 mein itni cheeze badal gayi hai, itna advanced ho gaya hai that I'm not minding the electronics on it and I love the quick shift.
As long as you have the facility of turning off all the electronics, they being there is not
but
a hurdle.
Just mean that should also be easy.
That
should not be cumbersome. Now,
so
you
for example,
the
button,
advantage.
The button, ABS off button, that is very good. Simply
button
just press it,
ABS
khatam
off.
Achha, you don't even know.
You know what is the biggest advantage of this motorcycle that I feel over every other motorcycle? Isko jis mode mein tum off karoge, usi mode mein on hoti hai. With exactly those settings.
And you can also change the mode on the fly
you can
without even stopping.
Yeah,
that
so
is also
just
very
throttle
good.
Down and just hold the mode button or just change karo. It is so easy, man. It is so easy.
Exactly.
मैं इसको ना हाईवे पे चला रहा था. आई वॉज बिकॉज आई गॉट इट एंड देन आई वॉज राइडिंग इट टू मेक अ वीडियो. मैं ना नए वाले मेरा ऑफिस ऑफ नोएडा शिफ्ट हो गया है. सो आई वॉज ऑन द एक्सप्रेस वे. आई टुक अ पिलियन विद मी. पता ही नहीं चला कि वेट ही नहीं पता चला.
डुगाटी पे गया था
मैं. डुगाटी पे गया था मैं. अपने पीछे एक पिलियन को बिठाया. मैं 90 किलो का आदमी हूँ, ठीक है. मेरे साथ जो बैठा था वो भी 90 किलो का आदमी है.
ओके
मेरे को वेट ही नहीं पता चला बाइक का. और क्या न्यूट्रल हैंडलिंग है, क्या बढ़िया चलती है.
एंड वन थिंग व्हेन यू टॉकिंग अबाउट पिलियन एंड ऑल, the seat even though it's a rally seat
it's
very
comfortable man.
yes
tumne standard wali nahi chalai tha. maine standard wali chalai hai.
acha
mujhe standard ki seat nahi pasand. mere ko ye rally seat pasand hai.
so for example when I compare it to the rally seat that you have on your Himalayan and this one this is so much more comfortable yaar.
it is
matlab components better honge, matlab cushioning better hogi. mehengi bike
hai. iski rally ki seat ki itni
thickness
hai. ha
thickness
aur wide bhi hai. ha so but
it's not a traditional rally seat, it's like a hybrid
but
sort of thing.
very nice.
comfortable.
it is very nice.
They never ever I felt any discomfort ke matlab hard lag rahi hai seat and something like that. it's perfect.
mere paas na is bike ke liye bura bolne ke liye kuch
hai nahi. zyada
nahi, वैसे मैं ज्यादा bike ki burai karta nahi but ye to matlab kamal ki bike.
but you know what I've heard from people whenever I've spoken to a couple of people about after riding this Ducati, is that Ducati best bike hai yaar. and people have commented that Ducatis are very unreliable
yaar.
That is a very important
point. Is that
point.
The case with modern Ducatis now? I don't know.
I haven't owned a Ducati.
Neither have I.
But I've heard from many people. For example, I will not take names. People are talking about Ducati that it can, you know, give up on you on in any sort of terrain. You are in the middle of a ride and it will not switch on. The electronics will fail you.
I don't know. I have not come across anything personally, so I would refrain from commenting on that. But it hasn't given me a reason when I was riding the Desert X also. Mereko kuch aisa bike mein na kuch laga nahi ki something can fail. It was a very reassuring motorcycle that, you know, okay, take me anywhere, I will go. Achha, iski handling kitni amazing hai. For a motorcycle that is so
handling is amazing,
far
amazing.
Off the ground.
Yeah.
Kya handling hai yaar, sports bike handling.
It's very easy to ride. And I do not have a lot of expert skills in off-road riding and all.
Neither do I.
But
still, 500 meter mein gir gaya.
But still riding it on the summer sprint, I rode it, you know, a good amount of time. I was not riding it very hard, but I felt very confident on the pegs.
And yeah, man.
Very light as it well. You don't feel that top heaviness, even top though there is nothing like a fuel tank that is on the side, so, like those KTMs and all.
Because I feel, iski jo tanki hogi na, iska tank is aluminium.
Tanki.
Abhi petrol ki tanki hai yaar. वो एल्यूमिनियम की होगी.
हाँ.
फिर जो वेट है ना इंजन का, इट इज एल ट्विन, राइट? इट इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड लाइक दिस, नीचे है. सो द वेट इज डाउन लो, ऊपर से खाली है.
डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन बेटर हो गया ना.
सो और तेरी बाइक तो वैसे ही इसमें फ्यूल रेंज ज्यादा दिखा नहीं रही, 60-80 की दिखा रही है. सो ज्यादा तेल भी नहीं है इसमें अभी.
अभी मैंने सुबह 500 का भरवाया था.
वो तो पी गई होगी,
वो एक्सप्रेस वे पी गई होगी, कह के चलाई थी.
बट यू नो, मतलब मेरा ये मानना है, अगर आप 27 लाख रुपए खर्च रहे हो, a bike should put a smile on your face every time you look at it and every time you ride. In that
it
sense,
definitely
this Ducati,
does.
It does,
yeah,
that.
It does that. So, when I rode it for the first time, when I took it from your home to my place, the only thing that I was thinking of, I mean, if there is one motorcycle that can really put a big, big smile and I can shout with happiness inside my helmet, this is the one motorcycle that that is absolutely doing that.
Yeah.
No other motorcycle. For example, if you even talk about the GS, I have not ridden the 1300. I've ridden the 1250, but it doesn't feel as exciting like this.
It cannot.
Uski
na dekh, pehli baat to uski jo geometry hai na, it is like the perfect compromise GS.
Yeah.
It is more of a road touring motorcycle, the GS.
And
with the 1970s.
What are the other options? GS is there, 1300 we haven't ridden. Whatever it is, I have, frankly feel it feels like a very docile sort of a motorcycle.
Chalai hai. Haan, maine bhi life mein tiger chalai hai. Badi wali chalai hai, tune 900 wali chalai hai.
1200 भी मैंने चलाई है, तेरी भी चलाई है, नई वाली भी चलाई है.
वो वाली बात नहीं है किसी, वो बात है ही नहीं वो वाली. उसमें जो इसमें तूने बेरी की 850 GS चलाई है?
हाँ हाँ चलाई है.
कैसी लगी इन कंपैरिजन टू?
आई फाउंड इट वेरी रफ,
है ना?
इट्स वेरी रफ and it's not exciting to ride.
It's not exciting.
That was my initial impression. Tiger 900 is much more exciting.
And even though Barry was running shorter gearing, which should have made it a lot more exciting to ride.
I have ridden the 950 Multistrada. Barry ke papa wali. For a good amount of time. It's a very good motorcycle.
But it's a road.
It's a road bias motorcycle,
road
but with a 19-inch front wheel.
Yeah, that's what.
But one thing that is common with, I think, most of the Ducati motorcycles is their handling. For all Ducati motorcycles, handling is something that I've observed
so,
as very good in all
that
the
is,
motorcycles.
That is, you know, a lot of people say it's in the company's DNA and whatever, and we consider it marketing bullshit and we just look at the product, but it really is with every Ducati. Have you ever ridden a Ducati that's not exciting to ride?
I don't think they know how. They don't know how to make
a
boring motorcycle.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm so happy, na. Like, this is a motorcycle that's not trying to be something that it is not. It is unabashedly focused on off-road riding, but it is good in every other element as well.
Yeah. So what I am thinking right now is that since I haven't ridden the Desert X Standard, what would that motorcycle feel like? Because I think that will be a perfect motorcycle.
It's the Desert X is easier to buy.
Yeah. Easier to buy, manageable seat height, is very capable off-road as well. Much better than the Tiger 900 in terms of handling. Power is there, excitement is there, balance is there, doesn't feel top heavy. So it ticks a lot of boxes. If you are able to, you know, make that initial investment of 22-21 lakh rupees and get invested in the Ducati premium brand.
So what I feel is nobody should stretch themselves thin to get a 20 lakh rupee motorcycle. Agar tumko mehnat lag rahi hai bahut zyada, bahut idhar udhar se paisa ikattha karna hai, bahut bada loan lena pad raha hai, bahut badi EMIs deni pad rahi hai to buy a 20 lakh rupee motorcycle, boss, this is a wrong decision. Hai na? Matlab, you cannot justify taking a lot of load and then buying a motorcycle. Ghar khareed lo. Matlab, make a practical investment. If you have that money, agar aapke paas paisa hai, then only buy a motorcycle that kind of costs this kind of money.
Okay?
And I would say this, if you have ridden some 2-3 years, बिग मोटरसाइकिल्स आपने टाइगर चला ली, इंडिया में तो सब भी एडवेंचर बाइक राइडर्स टाइगर से ही शुरू हुए थे. आपने टाइगर चला ली है 2-3 साल 4 साल, आप कॉन्फिडेंट हो, आपको अच्छा लगता है खड़े होकर बाइक चलाना एंड यू नो थोड़ा ट्रेल रेल करना, संस्कार वगैरह जाना अच्छा लगता है, देन दिस मोटरसाइकिल मेक सेंस. अगर आपके पास पैसा है, और मैं तो ये भी बोलूँगा, अगर आपके पास बहुत पैसा है और आप सोच रहे हो मैं डेजर्ट एक्स ले सकता हूँ, लेकिन मेरे पास है पैसा उस पर एक्सेसरी लगाने का, ये लगाने का, वो लगाने का, इफ़ यू कैन स्ट्रेच अप टू अ डेजर्ट एक्स रैली, गेट दैट मोटरसाइकिल, बिकॉज दैट मोटरसाइकिल इज लाइक द अल्टीमेट मोटरसाइकिल. मोटरसाइकिल्स एटलीस्ट इन द नेक्स्ट टू ईयर्स cannot get any better than this with the kind of equipment that is on this motorcycle, with the kind of excitement that this motorcycle generates. Plus, एक वो भी होता है ना, मतलब 27 लाख रुपए दे रहे हैं तो there is a feel good factor. More than anything, my motorcycle makes me feel good.
Yeah.
So, वो आपको
it's definitely something that that everyone should consider if they have the 20 plus.
If you have the money and this is and this is a conversation. This is only for a very handful of people. क्योंकि 27 लाख रुपए motorcycle पे देना इंडिया क्या वर्ल्ड में किसी भी पार्ट में यार कोई इजी बात तो है
नहीं.
इट इज अ वेरी एक्सपेंसिव मोटरसाइकिल बिकॉज स्किल वाइज लेट मी बी वेरी क्लियर. जो आप टाइगर 900 रैली प्रो पे कर पाओगे ना, आप उतना ही इस पे कर पाओगे, उससे ज्यादा नहीं कर पाओगे. दिस मोटरसाइकिल इज फार मोर केपेबल ऑफ वॉट योर राइडिंग स्किल्स आर अंटिल एंड अनलेस यू आर अ सी एस संतोष और आशीष राव राणे और अ ऋग्वेद बारगुजे. मैं तो इंडियन राइडर्स की बात कर रहा हूँ अभी तो. सो दिस इज नॉट समथिंग दैट यू थिंक दैट ओके आई एम गोना स्टार्ट राइडिंग इट एंड माय स्किल लेवल्स आर गोना गो हियर. नो, योर स्किल लेवल्स आर ओनली गोइंग टू इंप्रूव ऑन एन एक्सपल्स टू बिगिन विद. हाँ, देन अ हिमालयन, देन यू प्रोग्रेस लाइक दैट बिकॉज एन एक्सपल्स और अ हिमालयन विल ऑलवेज बी फास्टर हियर than you and me on a motorcycle like this, because वो डर रहेगा कि गिर जाएगी, ये हो जाएगा, वो हो जाएगा.
सो आई थिंक द मेन point after our discussion, if I have to summarize, I think Ducati has set a benchmark with this motorcycle.
Yeah,
I think so. And right now in the Indian, you know, motorcycling fraternity, specifically in the adventure touring space, people just think about Triumphs
or BMWs. GS chahiye, GS.
If you are considering one big adventure touring motorcycle, one thing that you should do is test ride this. Test ride it, go to the dealership and ask them that can I ride this bike for a good 1 or 2 hours. I'm pretty sure they will give you if you are serious enough buying this motorcycle. And then, and if you're in Delhi for example, my advice would be ride this. All the superbike showrooms are side by side. Then after that directly ride a Tiger 1200 or a BMW 1250 or 1300 GS, right? You will just, you know, resonate with what we are saying right now. It's totally different in terms of the feel. So that's my takeaway after riding this Ducati right now.
I echo the sentiment. I don't want to drag this long.
Yeah.
It's a very nice motorcycle. If I had that kind of money today to spend on a motorcycle, it's a no-brainer for me. I would buy this.
Yeah.
There is no other motorcycle I have ever ridden which is a better motorcycle at what it is supposed to be. Nothing comes close.
We'll hold to this statement that we have made till the time we see the KTM 890 Adventure coming to the market.
Yaar, wo KTM
let's close it now.
KTM
but I think
uske na camshafts thode solid bana de.
Yeah, but
uske baad dekhenge.
But net I think this later part, this last 3-4 months of 2024 is going to be very exciting for adventure touring motorcycles. Last year it was the Himalayan.
This time
it's going to be premium motorcycles that are going to come. Yeah. F900 GS is going to come.
Yeah.
And
I think
KTM.
It's already been launched, no, in India.
I haven't seen it. But anyways, F900 GS and the KTM 890R. These are, you know, much awaited motorcycles.
Since you just mentioned the Himalayan, I want to say something. You know, the Ducati Desert X Rally is what I'm trying to do to my Himalayan. My approach has been to make a rally like an extra hardcore version of the Himalayan. And I feel that it's common knowledge now that Royal Enfield is working on a raid version of the Himalayan. We don't know when it will be out, maybe 2026, 2027. That's going to be a slightly more aggressive off-road bias, maybe taller suspension, a little bit more power, lighter version of the Himalayan. Royal Enfield, if you're ever watching this part of this video, ever if you ever land up on this video, do what Ducati has done to the Desert X, to the Himalayan, the K1 X project.
That's a great blueprint to follow, basically.
That's a great blueprint to follow. Matlab, is bike pe na, everything is perfect. I think ho gaya.
Ho gaya.
Yes.
Done.
Thank you guys.
Bye. Now we should have something and, you know, go back to the trail.
Yes.
We are going through the same route.
Yes. But I want to ride the Himalayan. I don't want to drop the party.
Okay. Cool. We'll shut the video down, guys. See you in the next one. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.